Transitioning to automation in the manufacturing industry may seem like a monumental task, so why not start with a small bite? Automating even one step in your process can pave the way for a simplified and more streamlined process in the future. The graining application in our lab today is the first to be automated in our customer's process on frames for sliding doors. The stainless steel pieces you see here are segments of a larger weldment, but individual parts were used for easier fixturing in the lab. Since these stainless steel frames are used in high traffic areas, the customer requirement was that the visible surfaces have a linear grain pattern with a consistent and visually appealing finish. Graining is a great option for highly visible steel or aluminum parts, as it can help hide scratches, mill scale, and surface porosity. If you've never heard of graining, chances are high you have seen them in your day-to-day life. If you have a stainless steel fridge, microwave, dishwasher, or oven, there's a high probability that they have a linear graining pattern on the exterior surfaces. The customer currently uses a premium belt in their manual process. It's a good fit for automation, so we kept with their current abrasive for our lab trial. The media used for the project was 3M's 784F Cubitron 2 cloth belt. The mineral in this fast cutting belt continually fractures into sharp edges to maintain belt life, which reduces downtime in robotic processing. In conjunction, it features 3M's precision-shaped ceramic grain and works well on medium-pressure applications such as this one. From our current application and this similar stainless steel graining project using an expander wheel, we found that a pneumatic contact wheel was superior to an expander style for this specific use case. The pneumatic contact wheels can be inflated more or less to provide varying degrees of conformability. Less pressure will make the wheel softer, which helps push into any low spots or valleys on the parent material without removing too much stock. It also allows spinning at slower speeds while keeping the belt in place. An expander wheel, however, requires a fairly fast RPM to secure the belt onto the wheel. It increases in diameter the faster the wheel spins. Below a certain speed, the wheel will not expand enough and the belt will fall off. Additionally, the faster you spin, the harder and less conformable the wheel will act. Pneumatic wheels or drums conform to shapes, making them more effective than hard rubber wheels on parts with a lot of curves. Given the part parameters and varying curve depths, the contact wheel used was critical to the success in this application. A few challenges presented themselves while trying to set the grain on these parts. As you traverse back and forth over the parts, the small overlap between the passes can have a slightly different scratch pattern than the rest of the surface. To solve this, we ran multiple passes over the same areas with a slight step over each time. These soften these visual lines. Coated abrasives are made from grains that are attached to various backing materials, in this case cloth, and then coated with a bonding agent to hold them in place. As a result, there are high and low spots across the width of the belt. When these belts travel linearly across the part's surface, they can create visual lines. It's not an issue in manual processes because the operator isn't able to hold the path of the tool straight enough to leave a noticeable mark. The robot's rigidity holds the belt in the same place along its path, creating the lines. With the short belts used in this application, we ran a slow RPM to improve the visual finish. The trade-off here is there may be multiple passes required due to the slower cut. With a longer belt, this effect is mitigated as there's more media, which creates a more random-looking pattern. This particular part had too many tight features with limited access, otherwise we would have used the PushCorp RBS-372 due to its 72-inch long belt. The additional length not only helps with the graining pattern, but also provides significantly longer media life. After setting the grain with a coated abrasive, the next step is to blend the passes using a non-woven belt or wheel. The customer will do this step by hand, but utilizing a quick change spindle, the tool holder and abrasive can be changed out automatically to do both steps in the process with a single end effector. With the part's final appearance so important to the success of this project, PushCorp's AFD310 active compliance device was the perfect match. Its 20 millimeters of compliance stroke helps simplify the programming path along the contoured parts, maintaining a constant force. This constant force was key to achieving a consistent finish. Another key ingredient to a consistent visual finish was PushCorp's STC0605-BT30 Servo Spindle. It holds a constant RPM, rotating the belt at the same speed as it's moved across the part. In comparison, an air motor can bog down or speed up depending on the size of your contact patch or force applied. This spindle solution also leaves room for the customer to automate other steps in their process down the line with its automatic tool changing function. Let's put all this together. Check out the application video. Hey, welcome back. We create these videos to help explain material removal applications. If you have a process you think may be right for automation and want to see your parts in the demo lab, send an email to sales@pushcorp.com. To see a fully automated, multi-step process on stainless steel utilizing PushCorp's automatic tool changer, click the link to our robotic sanding and polishing stainless steel video in the description. If you enjoy these videos, please make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time.